the skin changes in pregnancy can be divided into two different groups. One group is the normal expected skin changes during pregnancy, and one that's abnormal or due to a medical condition. During pregnancy, you can expect that the skin may produce more pigmentation and there's increased melanin production due to the hormonal changes in the body. So you can expect, for example, darkening of the skin over certain areas of the body like the neck, over the axilla. You can get a pigmented line on the abdomen. So these are very common changes. You can also get a worsening of pigmentation on the face, particularly a condition which is known as melasma or the mask of pregnancy. So these are quite common changes that you see during pregnancy. And to reduce melasma, it is important for you to avoid the sun, as the sun will worsen the pigmentation. It's also for you important for you to use sunscreens, for example, an SPF of 30 and above when you go into the sun. So during pregnancy, the skin may become very itchy and the women tend to scratch a lot, and this can aggravate underlying medical conditions such as eczema. You can also develop a problem called PUPPP or pruritic urticarial papules and plaques of pregnancy. In this condition, you can get extensive red rashes on the abdomen and on the limbs, and this can also be very itchy and distressing for the patient. So in these conditions, you can consider seeking medical help. Most of the changes during pregnancy can be reversed after the delivery of the baby. For example, pigmentation may lighten somewhat after delivery, but there are also certain changes that may be permanent. So, for example, people may develop stretch marks during pregnancy. This is a common change that occurs in pregnancy. And after delivery, generally stretch marks do improve, but sometimes they can persist. During pregnancy, you can also get changes in the blood vessels. For example, you can develop veins, such as spider veins or varicose veins. So these changes also may be difficult to avoid, but there are things that you can do to try to reduce the development of such changes. For example, you can consider walking instead of prolonged standing, because as you walk, you improve the venous return, and this may reduce the risk of developing these veins and varicosities. Other things that you can do include elevation of the legs and even wearing things like compression stockings to reduce the risk of developing them. So there are some creams that we would prefer to avoid during pregnancy. An example is tretinoin cream. Tretinoin cream is quite a common cream that is used in, for example, anti-acne products and also for anti-aging. But it's preferable not to use these while you're pregnant. Some people like to go for treatments during pregnancy. Well, in general, I think that during pregnancy, I would usually try to minimize unnecessary treatments because of the unknown of whether this can affect the baby. However, there are treatments that may be medically necessary during pregnancy. For example, if you have a big abscess or a very bad infection that needs to be drained, then in such situations, you know, you should go for these procedures and not defer them, because deferring these would lead to bigger problems. After delivery, you can experience some skin changes. One of the more common changes that you may get is hair loss. And this is a condition which is called telogen effluvium. And this often occurs about 1 to 4 months after delivery. The hair can come out in clumps, but don't worry. This will usually stop within 2 to 3 months and you'll get back your hair. So nothing to worry about. Other common changes that you can get after delivery include the development of eczema, particularly hand eczema, because during the period post-delivery, you'll be looking after your baby, you'll be washing your hands a lot of contact with soap and detergents, and this can aggravate the eczema on the hands. So in order to prevent this, it is advisable for you to use soap-free washes and cleansers, and to generally avoid frequent washing of your hands. It is also important to use moisturizers, and if you have to do housework, it's useful to use gloves every time you do the housework.